Welcome to this step-by-step tutorial on how to create ad hoc grids in Oracle Planning and Budgeting Cloud. With ad hoc grids, you can personalize focus data slices that you frequently access. You can drag a dimension from one axis of the ad hoc grid to another, keep or remove members, zoom into members, apply formatting styles to headings and data. I'll open the data card and start creating a new ad hoc grid. Select a cube for your ad hoc grid. By default, a new ad hoc grid displays the account dimension on the row and the year and period dimensions on the column. The other dimensions are on the point of view or POV. Let's take a look at the ad hoc options. You can select member inclusion, display member names and or their aliases, select the level at which to zoom in, display ancestors at the top or bottom of the hierarchy, select an alias table, turn off data refresh while performing ad hoc actions, set indentation, hide rows or columns with zeros or no data and repeating members, select currency precision settings, replace text displayed for members with missing or no data. Next, let's open the Ad Hoc tab. You can perform tasks using the buttons in this tab, the Actions menu, or the Shortcut menu. You can position dimension members by dragging and dropping them between the POV and grid sections. You can pivot dimensions to the page, columns, or rows using these buttons or the Shortcut menu. Keep in mind that you cannot pivot the last dimension in a row or column. You can move dimensions in the page, row, and column sections to reposition them. Now, let's select members for dimensions in our page axis, starting with entity. Let's select members for the scenario dimension. When selecting members, you can use the search feature to locate specific members. You can also select members by clicking the Select Members button on the Ad Hoc tab. You can optionally choose to display member aliases when selecting members. I selected members for the version, year, and period dimensions. The page is refreshed with data for the selected members. You can further customize your ad hoc grid by keeping or removing selected members. Let's say that you only need to view information for FY17 and the working version. Use the Keep Selected and Remove Selected features to make changes. You can zoom into the next level, the bottom level, or zoom out one level of a dimension hierarchy to display members not shown by default in the grid. I'll show you. I'll zoom in to the next level of computer equipment. The descendants of computer equipment are displayed. Next, I'll zoom out computer equipment. Total product, which is one level above computer equipment, is displayed. Then, I'll zoom in to display bottom level members of total product. After you create an ad hoc grid, you can save it for future use. When you save the ad hoc grid, enter its name. Descriptions are optional. Then, select a folder where you want to save your ad hoc grid. I'll navigate to the folder. I can now access the ad hoc grid I created. In this tutorial, you saw how to create and save ad hoc grids in Oracle Planning and Budgeting Cloud. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.